I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, a very good defense will be on the field. The Saints are the least scored on team in the league, and they'll be up against the Falcons offense that will need to rise to the occasion.
Thank you very much, Larry. As usual, the streets of the nearby French Quarter are alive as we are in downtown New Orleans at the Mercedes-Benz Superdome. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it. This crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Atlanta Falcons and the New Orleans Saints. That's fielded in the end zone. And he's able to get it across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down at the 21-yard line. Here on first down. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that one falls incomplete. Looked like he might have had position there, but he couldn't hold on it at second down.
But one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you got to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. For the first time with Devontae Freeman. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. Give him 10 yards on that one, and that'll earn him a fresh set of downs. And a new set of downs here after picking up the first on the ground. Freeman again, a first down carry, and he'll get this only up to about the 35. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Not much happening there on first down.
I thought there might have been a hole for a split second.
Yeah, but it dried up pretty quickly, didn't it? Closed fast.
And on the outside, they're playing press coverage.
Here we go now.
To throw on second down, here's Webb. Escaping the pressure right. And some room to work. And he'll go out of bounds, it appears, right at the 45. Give him 10 that time, escaping the danger, running with it, and picking up a first down.
That was an excellent job of recognizing the situation. His first read wasn't there. Heck, his second read wasn't there. But he bought himself a little extra time scrambling out of the pocket, got to the sticks, and picked up the first down.
This is Freeman on first and 10. And no room that time, getting it to about the 46. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Nice job by that defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on first down. Well played, I must say.
Yeah, only getting 1 yard. There was no room to run. Play fake. Now Webb. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And he's unable to grab it. Thought he might have had position. Couldn't hold on. Third down.
This defense is not going to make it easy for you. They're a physical group, and we just saw it there on that play. He came in, made the contact, just as he's trying to haul it in.
And on third down, a nickel formation here defensively. The gun, it's Webb. Got a man, he finds Sanders. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. A big 30-yard play on third. So after that big gain, let's see what else the offense has up its sleeve.
Here we go now. Blue 90. Blue 90.
Back to the running game. It's Freeman. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Okay, let's just make this one simple. We know that the running game is not their thing, but they can't just throw it on every single down without expecting some real heat from the pass rush.
So now 11 yards to go for this offensive unit. It's second down.
All right, now, look at 56. Look at it. Hey. Now, let's go. Blue, Leopard. Leopard. Look free,
look free. Again, they'll run with Freeman. No dice this go around. He's hit behind the line and taken down. So he loses 3 yards there. Now third down. So add that tackle for a loss to the two that he had a week ago.
And you know what he's doing right now?
Smiling?
Yeah, definitely doing that. But he's also patting his guys on the back, his defensive front, because they're keeping him clean, meaning no one's getting to him as a blocker. He's able to run to the foot.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. Past the 10 to the 11-yard line, and that's where the return stops. They were ball hawks last week. They had a trio of interceptions on defense. In the first drive, they pick up right where they left off.
They're creating quite a reputation for themselves, aren't they? And sometimes what happens is when they know that the defense can take the ball away, as they saw the previous week, now you try too hard to not let them take it away, and you force yourself into errors. They've intimidated them, in a sense, and gotten the ball from them.
Now a first carry for Isaiah Crowell. And he'll get this one up to about his 14. Give him 3 on first down. It'll set up a 2nd and 7.
Well, they held him to a short gain on that one. And it almost felt like on that first run, they were trying to just throw the jab at him. So how do you stop a jab? Get closer and smother it, just as they did on that last play.
See if they stay on the ground for 2nd down.
Double tight, guys. Double tight. Ready. They play 5. Two kill. Ready. Easy kill down. Slam.
They'll run it again with Crowell. And he is swallowed up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so they're left with a 3rd down and 6. So nothing there. I don't know that that's all in the back, though. You got to look at blocking there, don't you?
I would agree with that totally. At some point, they have to win at the point of attack. Instead, it was the defense getting it done again and holding them to no gain.
On 3rd down, he finds Coleman, and he gets it to the 34. Good enough for the first. They call it a gain of 19, and it moves the chains. A first first down carry now for Crowell. And after the good gain last play, this time they say, as he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage. That'll be a loss of 4 yards on the play. And it'll bring up a second and 14. It's Coleman. They'll wind up getting 10 back as that sets him up for third down.
Well, that's what you're looking for when you're wanting to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Third down now following the completed pass. Throwing now is Breeze. And the third down pass falls incomplete.
Brandon, it looked like he had his hands on it for a moment, but let's face it, that was going to be a tough catch all the way because of the presence of the defense right there as he was trying to haul it in.
Yeah, nice job to force the incompletion. Here's Thomas Morstead on now to punt it away on fourth down. He only punted twice in the win last week as he gets this one away. And a nice special teams job here. This is going to be down inside the 10 at the 7-yard line. So out come the Falcons now. And the magnitude of this game, everybody knows it. The fans, obviously, the players and coaches, there's just with them a palpable buzz right now. They know they control their own destiny.
Win and you're in. And I think every player wants that. I think every coach wants that. I haven't been an organization yet that wants to be in a game where they have to rely on other teams to get them to their goals. In this situation, it's very cut and dry. Win and you're in the playoffs. That's their mission. That's their challenge. And you know they've chosen to accept it.
And what they told us is this has been the most focused week of practice we've had all year. You wouldn't expect any different.
Yeah, and you know, at the beginning of the season, you have multiple goals. They just have one now, winning the game.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, it's the Falcons in possession to begin quarter number two. But they face a second and long to start things out. Taken down right at the line. No gain on the play, and it'll bring up a third down.
And that's when it's fun to play defense. When you're able to diagnose a play right from the beginning, get all your guys to the football and spill the play, that's when you have a lot of fun playing on that side of the ball.
They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down.
Detroit! Detroit! Let's go! Green 39! Green 39!
Operating from the gun, Webb. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. They'll get 10 there, but it leaves them just short for fourth down.
I think that call was made not so much to try and get the first down, although they would have taken it if they could have gotten it, but to give their punter a little bit of space and try and help out their defense.
Yeah,
they
got the safe completion on third. On fourth down, here's Matt Bosher on to punt. He punted five times in the win last week as this one's away. And taken right on the 30. 21 yards. Well done on the return. And the Saints will have a short field in front of them. They take over here first and 10. It'll be second down. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Mike 50, ready.
Second down, here's Breeze. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. Breeze finding Snead there for a Saint first down.
If you're running out route, it's likely you end up near the sideline. And what did we just see there? You got it. The benefits of practice. Toe tapping, foot dragging, picking it up, and making sure it was a catch.
Here's a give to Crowell. And able to push his way forward here for a good little gain. Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6. Tough running there. That's a hard-earned 4 yards.
Yeah, those are the unsung kind of runs. They don't fill up the stat sheet, but they do set you up in good position on second down.
Throwing on second down. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. It goes as a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. Just 7 yards down to the 17.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
Well, they don't need to run another play here before the 2-minute warning. Let's see if they do it anyway. Remain in a scoreless first half. We're back to New Orleans after this. Second down. Looking for Snead, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Landon Collins. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
Brandon, this is why golfers do their best to never count a score in their head before the ball goes in the cup. This looked like a slam dunk for points on this drive, didn't it? Instead, they throw an interception, and they're going to come away empty.
And tough starting field position here.
Boom,
They go play action here on first down. They'll let it go deep for Beckham. And it drops down incomplete. Thought he might have had it. Instead, second down.
But one thing that I've liked defensively is that they've shown him a lot of different looks here in the first half. They've come after him. They've sat back. I think that's what you need to do to keep an offense guessing.
And they certainly have kept them on their toes. That's why they haven't had much success on the scoreboard. Back to the air on second down. Webb. And his throw's going to be incomplete. He was looking for Odell Beckham that time. And that takes us from second to third down.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
Play action, it's Webb. And he comes back with one complete. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. It's a pickup of 16 there, and it'll lead to a new set of downs.
Let's go.
Now a first down throw, Webb. Dancing to his left. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. He'll get just a yard on the scramble. It's second down. Webb trying to get him to the line and set quickly.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
On second down, Freeman. And not a whole lot doing there as he'll get it up to about the 28-yard line. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
Well, he hasn't made much of an impact in the running game thus far, and after that last run, not much is going to change in that area.
He hasn't been able to get anything going, and really the offensive line not helping him much. The Falcons on third down. They've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This is third and 7. From the gun, Webb. Sanders has it over the middle. And he's going to have the first down at about the 38. It's a 10-yard pickup, and it moves the chains. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 13 seconds to play in half number one. And getting our first update now from Nashville. And it's the Titans who are off to the early lead in that ball game. That one tight to this point, and you'd have to imagine it'll stay tight throughout.
Here we go. Hey, 19.
Off play action. Webb. He's going to sling this deep downfield, and that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee. Trying to disrupt Julio Jones there, the intended target. A little too close, got the flag thrown.
I'm not sure anyone can cover Julio Jones one-on-one for very long without getting their share of pass interference calls. His size, his speed, his physicality makes it almost impossible to do.
And here comes play number 6 on this drive. Down, it's Webb. And this is incomplete with a clock showing just 3 seconds left. The Pro Bowl wideout Julio Jones is intended receiver. And that'll bring up second down. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And Vinatieri's kick is good. So we've come upon halftime here in week 17 as we send you on over to Orlando where we'll check in with Larry Ridley. He's got our EA Sports halftime report. Larry? Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Out come the Saints now. They'll go on offense first here to begin the third quarter. They're down here, but very much in this game. What's the tonality of a coach's talk when a game is within striking distance like this at intermission?
Typically, what they're doing is emphasizing the things that went well in the first half and wanting more of that. Sure, you've got to go over some of the errors and clean up some things because there's a reason you're down. But overall, I think they want to stay positive, stay up with this team. We're just starting the second half, and we've got the football. Let's go ahead and punch it in, and then we'll take it from there.
See how that recipe works. Second half begins with a run by Crowell. And this has been a familiar sight all afternoon as they stop him behind the line.
I think it's pretty evident we can say what a difference a week makes. Last week, he ran pretty much wild, didn't he? Did pretty much what he wanted to do. But this one, they stopped him cold. That, to me, that's good scouting and even better execution.
Yeah, and they stopped him behind the line right there. They obviously watched the tape a few times and made some adjustments. The throw to the left side caught by Coleman. And he is hit pretty hard from the side as he's knocked down. It's a gain of 11 yards that time, and it produces a new set of downs. Fresh set of downs here. Off to his fullback. Just a 1 yard pickup on the play, and it's a second down. So second and nine, the defense looking to put them in a bad spot here. Now. And the Falcons get there. The Falcons get the sack. Down he goes. Grady Jarrett in there to drop him for his fifth sack of the year. Third and long now after the sack of Breeze, and the Saints up against it here. To the 43-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 13, but it'll still lead to a fourth down.
Receivers love having the reputation of being go-to guys on third down, and he was fighting like he really wanted to have that reputation, didn't he? I mean, he came very close to making that a first down.
Broke the one tackle, but couldn't spring himself free. He gets this one away, and boy, it's another boomer. And a little too much mustard on that one. It hits a couple yards into the end zone. A missed opportunity there maybe to pin him back. Now we take a glance at the offense as they work their way back out for their first possession of the second half. They were able to get the ball back here, didn't surrender any points. Now they'll look to add to that lead.
Yeah, how about the boost the defense gave them? Going right out on the field, shutting them down, not giving up any points, and turning the ball back over. They want to do their part now and show them a little respect and some gratitude by scoring some points.
And to get a little more cushion. And he'll find some space up to about the 25. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Sometimes with the running game, you've just got to stick with it. Look, it's the third quarter, no time to panic. But that also doesn't mean you just do it the same way you've been doing it the entire ball game. Maybe change up some blocking assignments or run a few different plays, but stay with the overall essence of the running game.
Looks like the defense in press coverage here. On On second down, Webb. And the pressure will get to him. He goes down. Now, there is a flag on the play, but this looks like holding on the offense. So they will take the sack instead of the penalty.
And it takes another down off the series. But the biggest one of all, do you want to tell the guy who just got the sack that it no longer counts?
No.
No, not at all.
The Falcons on third down. They've converted 3 out of 5 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Operating from the gun, Webb. It's caught, Jones. A gain of 19 and picking up the first. Those are the kinds of plays right there that show you why he's the number 3 man in the NFL in terms of receiving yards.
Also tells you there's a full combination of what he's got going in his game. You name it, from route running to catching the football. That's why he's able to produce those types of numbers.
And the offense lining up 1st and 10. Webb. They'll set up the screen for Freeman. And he'll get it out to midfield. Looks like, yeah, they'll spot it right at midfield at the 50. A good pickup there on first as the screen pass gets him 8.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid game.
From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. Swings it out to the flat for Freeman. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It'll go as a gain of 6 that time, and it moves the chains as well. Down to the 42.
Well, they're hoping that the second half is better for him than the first half. They've got to find a way to get him going. He's a big part of their offense.
So the offense now dealing with a 2nd and 7. The wide receiver moving to a new spot. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
They're trying to show that they can run the ball, protect this lead, give it to the backs, play a little bit of keep away, don't you think?
And that's probably a good philosophy at this point, going to make that defense stand up and stop them. Carry for Freeman. They find some open field here. And he is leveled. Knocked down hard at the 19. A really nice pickup of 14 yards, and it moves the sticks. Back now here live in New Orleans. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the 4th quarter. Elsewhere, a 3rd quarter score. You saw the score at the bottom of your screen a moment ago. We got a good one going on there. Remember to keep an eye on the ticker, of course, at the bottom of your screen for updates on that game and others around the NFL. Freeman again. And he'll wind up losing yardage here back at the 21-yard line. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down. And the trend continues here in the 4th like it was in the 1st, 2nd, and 3rd. He's had nowhere to run.
And you're probably thinking to yourself, why do they keep feeding him the football? Well, they trust him first and foremost. They do believe that over time he might actually pop one of these runs.
And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Odell Beckham hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season. And the Falcons will extend their lead. It's up and good, and that'll increase their lead to 10-0. Here's Bosher to kick it away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. The Saints offense now, they get ready to head back onto the field. And with this deficit, you can't have too many more drives like the last drive where you had to punt it away.
You know what I would tell my offense right here? The punter doesn't exist, guys. He doesn't even exist. He's not a team anymore. I just cut him, all right? So you've got to go out and create some offense for us here and give us some points. No way does that guy get on the field on this drive.
Poor punter.
Yeah, it wasn't his fault.
Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Vic Beasley in there to drop him, and his great season continues. 13 sacks for him now on the year. Breeze now to throw. Throwing the out route incomplete. It's Coleman. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. You cannot write these guys off just yet, not with a quarterback like that under center.
You mean it actually crossed your mind with him running the team that you could actually maybe write this game off?
Not yet.
Not a chance. Not with him. We've seen it too many times.
The Saints on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 7. Breeze going to throw. And no escaping this time as he'll go down. They got him for a sack. Vic Beasley in there to get him. Sack number 14 for him on the year. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They'll be down to 2 remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. And they're indeed going to go for it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter, let's see how this plays out. And they're going to go soft on the corners. Gotta have this one. Over the middle, the catch by Coleman. And they'll get it all the way out near midfield to the 45. Give them 22 on that one. And the Saints are gonna get a first down. Now Breeze. He's just gonna dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. 12 more yards there and another first down. Even though this offense doesn't have a single point to its name, they're not totally out of this game yet. A touchdown here, they could be in business.
And how about that last play? Now they've got momentum going. So, you know, I'm a big advocate. Get back on the line of scrimmage. Throw another play at them while you've got them rocked on their heels.
Defense really showing respect to the deep ball here, playing off the receivers.
Here we go. Switch. 21.
Breeze now on first down. Smith catches left side. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. It's a 4-yard pickup, and that'll make it second down. Again, they'll throw with Breeze. And he fires one incomplete.
The positioning here is key. As a defensive back, you're taught 99% of the time, make a play on the football. But in this case, making a play on the man was all the difference. That's what forced the incompletion.
The Saints on third down. They've only converted once in 4 tries. This will be 3rd and 6.
Opposite,
Breeze to throw again. Fighting through pressure. Eluding the pressure right. He may try and run for this. So he fought off the tackle, and that effort gives him the first before he's brought down. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Here's Breeze to throw. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down. A pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
Offense looking to avoid a third and long. It's second and 10. Throwing now is Breeze. Over the middle to Smith. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. A good gain of 14 there, and it moves the chains. On the run, it's Crowell. Oh, no, he lost the football. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back.
As they say, this game hasn't exactly been one for the books. I mean, we're into the fourth quarter here, and now this happens, another turnover. Not one that they're going to hold up and say, yeah, this has been a banner day.
Absolutely. Still sitting on zero. And not great starting field position here for the offense. Now on first down, he's going to sneak it. No gain there as he kept it himself at second down. And in this situation with the lead fourth quarter, they're liking keeping the ball on the ground, I'm sure.
That's just smart football, but you know the defense has to know it as well. They've got to stop them here. So now we're going to see that loading the box in a big way. 6, 7, 8, 9, whatever it's going to take, puts a little bit more pressure on your big offensive line.
Freeman. 1 yard, the official pickup there, so it's going to set up third and 9.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner, and there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here if they have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. The Falcons on third down. They've converted 4 times out of 6. Not bad. This is 3rd and 9. To throw from his end zone. Webb. And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete.
Well, the fans should be applauding this defense right now. It's an excellent job. They force a 3 and out, and they should be able to set up their guys with great field position, probably near midfield or better.
Here's Matt Bosher now, on for his second punt. He'd take a repeat of his first. So a short drop, but he's able to get it out, and this is a good kick. Time for a break. We're back to finish this one off after this. And they'll start this drive with very good field position. Now Breeze. Pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. Breeze, one of the best ever in these situations as he's trying to get his guys set.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
To throw is Breeze. Caught right side, it's Snead. 17 yards on the pickup there. The drive will continue. It's a first down. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
Meanwhile, in Nashville, they're on to the fourth quarter now. And the Titans have just scored, so they add on to their lead. Another victory perhaps in the cards. They're looking as good as anybody as the playoffs draw near. Back to throw, Breeze. This throw caught right around the six. And able to get him down, but he does reach the five. Another big gainer that time. This one goes for 19 yards. We'll try and run for it with Crowell. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. Isaiah Crowell, touchdown number 22 on the season. And the Saints have cut it back within a score. Will Lutz on for the point after. And they're back within a field goal. It's 10-7 now. So a minute and change to go, and this is going to be an onside kick. And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it. Well, fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
They run from the pistol here with Freeman. And he'll get inside the 40 to maybe the 38-yard line. A gain of three, second down. Now a second timeout called for by the defense. That'll leave him with just one remaining in this fourth quarter of play. Seven yards to go on second down. Running right, this is Freeman. And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. And now we're going to get a timeout here called by the defense. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. Play action, it's Webb. Looking deep for Julio. And this is caught. And that could seal it. It's a touchdown.
And that touchdown should make you feel comfortable But do you really feel like it's totally over yet?
Not totally, but I think you're pretty much there.
Yeah, you've still got to make sure you stay with it, do all the right things down the stretch, especially on defense. But that touchdown there, you've got to feel good about your chances.
Meanwhile, in Nashville, they're on to the fourth quarter now. And pushing up their lead, the Titans have scored again. Another victory perhaps in the cards. They're looking as good as anybody as the playoffs draw near. Here's Bosher to kick it away. Out onto the field comes New Orleans. They might be thinking this is close to a lost cause here. Got to play it out. What do they need to do?
Well, they have a thought process in mind already, but they can't get ahead of themselves. They know that they need to score quickly.
Yep, two-score game.
Onside kick and get the ball back and then score again. But they can't worry about the last 2 points. The only thing that matters is scoring quickly, then they'll take it from there.
And Charles, in this situation, this is where the word miracle comes into play.
Have to score real fast, maybe throw a jump ball in the end zone and hope for the best.
Now Breeze. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Ford. A good pick up there, 26 yards. First down now, but that clock rolling.
Of course, the catch was nice, but how about what happened after? Able to stay on his feet and gain all that additional yardage. So many of these slot guys, I think, have running back in their background.
And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Okay, partner, hyperbole alert, all right? I think that this has got to be the best game I've seen this secondary play this entire season. Doesn't matter whether they've been a man, zone, they've reacted, communicated, and really made plays on the football.
They absolutely have. And the play on that last deep ball. And this is intercepted. And that should do it. Picked off at the 15. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35.
Obviously disappointing, but you had to go for broke here, down 2 scores. So that forced you to make some throws you definitely wouldn't want to make. And I think this interception is going to pretty much write an end to this one.
Looks like he'll throw here. And off his back foot, he'll heave this one deep. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining.
And it is true. You can draft the fastest. You can draft the most athletic guys. But if they don't know the art of positioning, sometimes it's all for naught. In this case, in the right spot, he'll force the incompletion.
Yeah, but had his hands on it for a second. Would have been a tough catch, though. Falls incomplete. So incomplete on first. Let's see what second down has in store. Throwing again. Webb. He's going to loft one deep left side here. That's caught inside the 20. A road win in the National Football League. Charles, you never take that for granted, no matter who you're playing, no matter where you're playing.
You take it and you run with it. And you know you primed the pump all week in your own home facility. No one thinks we can do this. Only people who believe are right here in this room. And then you go on the road, band together, and get it done.
So for the Falcons, a final win means they will finish off the regular season at a very strong 12-4. And now they'll await the final seeding for the playoffs ahead. Meanwhile, for the Saints, this was basically just an exhibition game for them as they'd already clinched home field advantage. And the playoffs will run through their house as they'll get the week off and get set to host a divisional round game in 2 weeks' time. That'll do it for us. For Charles Davis and all our hardworking crew, I'm Brandon Gaughton. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, find us on Twitter at EA Madden NFL. Till next time, we say so long from the Bayou.
Falling too fast to prepare for this. Tripping in the world could be dangerous. Everybody circling as vultures. Negative, nepotist. Everybody waiting for the fall of man. Everybody praying for the end of times. Everybody hoping they could be the one. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Feeling miserable, always hanging on to the visual. I wanna be invisible. Looking at my years like I'm out of dumb. Everybody needs to be a part of them. Never be enough from the prodigal son. I was born to run, I was born for this.
Whip, whip, run me like a racehorse. Pull me like a ripcord. Break me down and build me up. I wanna be the slip, slip. Word upon your lip, lip. Rather that you rip, rip. Break me down and build me up. Whatever it takes.
Hypothetical, working out of something that I'm proud of. Out of the box, an epoxy to the world and the vision we've lost. I'm an apostrophe. I'm just a symbol to remind you that there's more to see. I'm just a product of the system of catastrophe. And yet a masterpiece. And yet I'm half diseased. And when I am deceased, at least I go down to the grave and die happily. Leave the body of my soul to be a part of me. I'll do what it takes.
Whatever it takes.
Know your place, yeah, know your place, yeah. I got like right now, I'm impatient. I got women on the cell trying to give me. I still wish it, would. I still wish I'm well, yeah. Yo. Put my problems in, Only check up when the checks come. My pockets looking best up. All the talking never stressed us. They talking like they jealous of me. They talking like they never love me. They talking like they next door. I still treat them like the sun. Showers on the way. I've been working 25 hours every day. Pull up with the Benz, have them dancing in the rain. Pull up with the Benz, have them dancing in the rain. Yo. Know your place, yeah, know your place, yeah. I got life like right now, I'm impatient. I got women on the cell trying to get me. I still wish it, would, I still wish I'm well, yeah. Yeah. I got life that right now, I'm impatient. I got women on the cell trying to get me. I still wish it, would, I still wish I'm well, yeah. Promises and wishes, candles for my exes now. Ain't no fingers left to count my blessing now. Promises and wishes, trust me, it's been different now. No rings for the things I go missing now. Promises and wishes.